gonna be transformed. Something else. You gonna see it on his body. It's gonna be crazy, new, aggressive, everything. Take a look. And now, the first thing I did yesterday, or I should say the first thing I did on this car when I got it, I flushed the radiator system. Because the temperature gauge is going up and down. And I need to replace this cap soon. And the vacuum line for the air intake, I put a tape on it for now, the temporary, just for now. Because it got like a hole in the hose. But it wasn't giving no problem, like it was misfiring. So far, everything's good. Sooner or later, or the next thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna change the oil and check the brakes. And I don't got no oil leak or nothing. So I'm gonna flush out the whole oil system and see what we're working on. Good, interiorized, good. So I'll catch you guys in the next one. Something simple. I thought it would be harder than this, but it's not that hard. I just took out the thermostat. I have like 3 bolts. See? 3 bolts. One there, and one on the floor. 3 bolts. That's for the thermostat. Before you take it off, you can't get the bolt all the way in this far corner. It's a sensor. Right here. You disconnect it, you move it out the way so you can get to the bolt. That's right here. And the hose is gonna be on a thermostat up top. You take off the hose clamp, and you can move around freely. And there's a hose clamp at the bottom too. But I took it out already with the hose. And once you gotta have a catch bucket under the bottom, so whenever you take off the thermostat, the extra fluid that's up top, you could drain out in the bucket. The reservoir sits like right here. This is the air vacuum for the reservoir. You have one here that's connected to the reservoir and one that's connected to the, yeah, this one is for the reservoir. You got both of them, two of them. One connect here and one connect here. This is the one for the vacuum line. This connect right here. So I disconnect this one because I'm about to flush the system with some water. Because the radiator is cracked up, but I don't want to take it off fully. Because the AC condenser is connected at the gas. It's building one here. So I don't want to disconnect it so all the fuel will come out. So I don't want to redo the AC fluid. So I think of another way to flush out the system. And I think that's the best way for the water holder to try to flush out the system. So yeah, catch you back guys in the next one.